community is increasingly aware of the need not to proceed with coal mines like Adani. And when governments are heading in the opposite direction, it creates a conflict and a real break between the population and our government.
We choose coral! We choose life!
Where mining starts and government ends, it's a very blurry line, my friends.
An independent is the only way you will have a voice in Parliament.
As we stand here today, there are thousands of people mobilising in India marching to close down the coal mine. And when Australians awaken from our slumbers and gather together in great numbers, we're not frightened to take a stand and drive corruption from our land. We are the people and we say enough!
We've known about climate change for a long time, and we also know that pre-industrial levels there were 275 parts per million of carbon dioxide particles in the atmosphere. Only a year or so ago, that figure was announced that it's now over 400 parts per million. That's where I feel too. Now, there's a quote in the Cairns Post the other day.
We're not about to do something that we know will be of detriment to the Great Barrier Reef.
Well, of course they're having an impact. You don't call oil or gas. You get carbon dioxide in the atmosphere, you crack the ground, you have CSG wells, you get methane in the atmosphere.
95% of the coral north of Cooktown is bleached, some of it irreparably, and coal mining directly contributes to bleaching events such as this.
So obviously we hear from sceptics all the time about climate change, but do you attribute this bleaching to climate change?
You can't be a sceptic any longer. It's denialist now. And it is directly due to climate change.
Everything frozen on Earth is melting. The great ice sheet of the Arctic is reduced by more than half. The oceans are about 30% more acidic than they were 30 years ago because the chemistry of seawater changes as it absorbs carbon from the atmosphere.
This country is not yet headed in the right direction, as many countries are, in the move towards renewable energy and addressing issues of catastrophic climate change.
Shall we work through the numbers? They're three, and they're easy. The first one's 2 degrees. That's how much the world has said it would be safe to let the planet warm. Second number, scientists have calculated how much carbon we could pour into the atmosphere and have a reasonable chance of staying below 2 degrees. They say about 565 more gigatons. A gigaton is a billion tons. The problem is we pour 30 billion tons a year in now, and it goes up 3% a year. Do the math, and it's about 15 years before we go past that threshold. So that's sobering news. But the scary number is the third number.
From a team of financial analysts in the United Kingdom, and figure out how much carbon the world's fossil fuel industry, how much they had already in their reserves. And that number turned out to be 2,795 gigatons worth of carbon, 5 times as much as the most conservative governments on Earth think would be safe to pour into the atmosphere.
We can prevent coral bleaching, and it gets back again to making sure coal mines, whether it's Adani or other new coal mines, don't proceed, and we transition away from coal to renewable energy.